Hello, my name is Francesca, and welcome to my new kitchen. I know that I'm always saying welcome to my new kitchen, but as you can see, we have moved house again. I have explained in a video, in a couple of videos, why we had to move house, but never mind all the troubles, we are here in a beautiful new place and we'll be very happy. This is a truly beautiful house, so from now on all my videos will come from this kitchen. What are we going to cook today? Something very naughty and very good. Gin and tonic cake. Yes. You probably have never heard of gin and tonic cake, neither have I. But there you go. I think that it is going to be absolutely awesome. This is from the magazine of a supermarket, so bear with me, it's a little bit torn. But it is going to be a very, very simple recipe, the kind of recipes I like, and very tasty. I don't know whether Colin manages to zoom in on the recipe.
He already did, and now he will again.
And I'll be reading it for you as well.
That will be helpful, because it's not easy to see.
And it is marvellous that we have Sir Colin with us today.
Yes, we do.
So, doesn't it look lush? Actually, I don't like the word lush, it sounds a bit silly, but it does look lush, I think. There you go. And as some YouTube friends of mine say, it is like they are here in my kitchen. And it is true. I hope you all join me. We'll be cooking away, chatting. Soon we intend to find some kind of an island to put here so that I can modestly be chatting with you, but we are not that far yet. So now I'll have to cook a bit sideways and try to speak to you at the same time. It is very nice that we have lovely, lovely music playing. I love music, you know, if you know me a bit. You know, if you don't know me yet, you'll get to know me quickly enough. So I hope you drop by, you subscribe to my channel, leave some comments and let us know whether you like our videos, what we can do better, anything, just chat away. And I'll subscribe to your channel as well. And please leave a like, because the likes make us work even harder. Although we always work hard, so it's not even true that likes make us work harder. But there you go, we are going to start. I'm going to use this beautiful tin in the shape of a heart. And if you know me, you know that I'm always trying out new recipes, so I have no idea whatsoever what is going to come out. I guess this is a nice size. If not, next time I'll adapt it. So this is the tin then. I have a lot of beautiful tins which I buy whenever they are cheap. Then we need 200 grams of butter. If you use cups, you can convert. I always use baking butter, which is quite cheap, and there are a lot of different brands. Then we'll be needing, of course, with a little bit for greasing, but you know, all about greasing. 175 grams of sugar. I am going to use 160 because I find all recipes, or most recipes, are far too sweet. I don't have a sweet tooth. I'm not at all a sweet person. No, I am sweet, but I don't like very sweet stuff. So this, whenever I can, I use dark sugar. I don't like using white refined sugar, which is kind of dead, you know, all life has been beaten out of it. So dark sugar is a lot tastier. I only use white sugar for caramel, because with dark sugar you can't see when the color turns. Then we'll be needing 4 large eggs, which I have here, beaten. I'll just throw them in, and my, what do you call this thing? My
mixer.
My mixer, that's true.
I was thinking about whisks.
I've been on the gin already. No, that's not true. But I was thinking about whisks, and this of speaking 7 languages is not a good thing. Not at all a good thing. So the mixer will be mixing them, so I like everything very simple. I won't be, you know, whisking them in a bowl and so on. So for 200 grams, I've torn this, so it's a bit difficult to read. 200 grams of self-raising flour, plus 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder. I actually didn't have baking powder, but I had cream of tartar and bicarbonate of soda. So you can go online, it's 1/4 teaspoon of bicarbonate of soda and 1/2 teaspoon of cream of tartar, and you have 3/4 teaspoon of baking powder. Then 1 teaspoon of juniper berries, which I'm a little bit worried because the husks are a bit hard. I don't know in the cake how that will work, but it smells. Ah, it smells very, very good. And I suppose juniper berries are used in the gin. I think that's probably the philosophy behind using the juniper berries. And the zest of 1 lime. Actually, I should have had 2 limes, because for the icing I need lime again, and I just have 1. Trust me to forget half of my shopping, even if I make a list, always forget half of it. And 75 mils of gin. Chin chin. Oh no, I can't drink it. Got to use it for the cake. But to start with, my apron. I don't want to, for sake of being fashionable, to have my clothes all dirty. So I won't be fashionable, and I'll wear my apron, which actually is beautiful. So.
And actually, you always look fashionable, even in an apron.
Even in my slippers.
I'm not sure.
But we are at home among friends, so there you go.
Very elegant.
Very. First thing is, we are going to beat the butter with the sugar. I have already pre-warmed the oven, because these modern ovens make such a lot of noise that it's actually quite horrendous if you are filming. So it's kind of half warm, and I'll warm it a bit more as we go. Grease, beat the butter and the sugar, and then gradually add the eggs. There you go, sugar, butter. I'm not used to cooking in this kitchen yet, so bear with me. I keep losing everything. And we have moved a bit over a week ago, so we have hardly ever eaten here. By the way, I used London dry gin, but you can use any gin if you like. Actually, the recipe says use Welsh gin. We are in Wales, and I don't have any Welsh gin, so that's very very silly. Actually, it is very nice that this butter, which is special for baking, it's not as expensive as real butter, although it's quite real butter, but not really. I don't know, I can't explain that to you. But anyway, it's cheaper. It's kind of soft, so you don't have to leave it out of the fridge for a while. Now we need four eggs.
I'll just put a bit in the cake.
and a bit afterwards in the, on the icing. And one thing, always sift your flour because you get a much lighter cake. If you don't have the self-raising flour, you can find how to add baking powder to flour and you end up with exactly the same type of flour. You just need to have the right ratio of baking powder and flour and you'll be okay. So you actually don't need to have a different type of flour at home. Turn the oven on again. I don't know why the ovens now make such a huge amount of noise. Oh, I'm the genius. So, I hope we find a suitable table and next time I'll be cooking from my island. I suppose it's desire of any baker and cook to have an island. There it goes. 75 mils of gin. Prost. A sua saúde, like we say in Portugal. It is a lot. What a waste. I could have been drinking it. I don't think I've ever tried gin. I've tried gin and tonic. If you want any explanations about this recipe or any other recipe that I've made in the past, please contact me and I'll be more than happy to tell you what I know. I'll share everything I know. If I don't know it, I can find out, I can Google. I've been cooking for so many years that I have a cousin in Portugal called Maria Luisa, who is a wonderful baker. She's really professional. So what I don't know, I can ask Luisa. I hope this batter is not too little for this baking tin, which is quite big. Otherwise, we end up with a tiny cake. It's going to be at least unusual, and I think it's going to be a very, very good cake. Just imagine if you invite your friends for a boozy evening and instead you serve them a cup of steaming tea and gin and tonic cake. I don't think they'll be disappointed. As soon as they try the cake, they'll forget all about the boozy evening. There you go. Try to get as much out as possible because the tin is quite big. So what I'll do is leave the cake probably in the oven for maybe 30 minutes. I'll check about, they say 40 to 50, but because it's not, the tin is not that full, I'll check probably after 30 minutes, 35 minutes with a cocktail stick, and if it comes out clean, the cake is ready. There we go. I must say that I profoundly dislike this British idea of having two tiny ovens instead of a normal oven. And they are so small, and the lower one is almost on the floor, so I don't like it. Oh, it's a beautiful kitchen, but this oven, no, not one of my favorites. And then there is another tiny little oven with a grill. The other has no grill. But if you want to bake two cakes at the same time, for example, or two oven dishes, then you have got to use electricity twice. It is not clever. I've already said I'm coming back as a missionary, and I'm going to teach a few things to the British. And one of them is no double ovens. You don't need a double oven. So let's say 35 minutes, and I'll come later and I'll have a look. If the cake is not baked yet, I'll leave it for a bit longer. One thing is, don't open the door before the time is halfway, because otherwise your cake will collapse. Although you'll still be able to eat it, it won't be very good. So, see you later. Here is the cake. I think, I'm not sure whether it is a little bit overbaked, but I don't know this oven yet. And anyway, we have an oven expert coming in a few days to see whether everything is working well. And I can't find my cocktail sticks for some reason. You know, when you tidy your kitchen and then you can't find anything. So I'm going to use a painting brush, going to make some holes and pour a bit of gin over it. So. Ooh, it's hot. Ah. Yeah, not a good idea. Anyway, you get the idea. You just make holes all over. You don't need to add more gin if you don't feel like it, but it is quite a good idea, because I think it will taste marvelous, and I love moist cakes. So if you're like me, please do make the holes and pour a bit more gin as soon as the cake comes out of the oven, right away, so that it absorbs well. There you go, just maybe 2 tablespoons. Mmm, still very hot. I hear it. So I think it's okay, because we also don't want it very, very wet, and we still keep a little bit of gin for ourselves. So the cake is going to cool off. I think it's a nice height, and then I will fetch a very nice plate, put it on the plate, make the icing later, and drizzle the icing over the top. So we'll remove the cake from the tin when it's cooled. See you later. So, here we are again, and we are going to finish our gin and tonic cake. Ooh, my hands are smelling wonderfully. I've been grating the rind of
lime.
Oh, they smell so wonderfully. And the juniper, the tonic, the gin, oh, what's not to like? And of course, my cherry earrings, because it is spring, so the cherries will be coming soon. Now, we only need to make the icing. That's going to be, as they say in Britain, easy peasy, I find. Easy peasy sounds kind of funny, but never mind. If you are in Britain, do like the British. That's the most important. I have here 125 grams of icing sugar, which I've sifted. It is a lot easier to use a food processor. Put the icing sugar there, the lime juice, the lime rind, and the tonic water. But if not, do sieve it, because otherwise you'll get all the little, you know, clumps of sugar, which if you think you manage to dissolve, you don't. So either sieve it, either use a food processor. I am now finished grating my lime. I've also grated a bit of lime, a bit coarser, using this grater to then throw on the top as decoration. And I'm going to grate a little bit more. It's an excuse to be chatting. So, it's always good. We have marvelous music playing. It's nice and warm here. It is very cold outside. By the way, we don't have our island yet, but I think next week we will. We have just ordered a beautiful camping table, and we'll be putting it here, and I'll be cooking and chatting. I think it is every cook's dream to have an island, and we'll have one soon. As you can see, this is a truly beautiful kitchen. I've been blessed over and over again with very, very nice kitchens. I used to live in France, I had a beautiful kitchen there. Actually, I lived at 3 addresses in France, and each one had a beautiful kitchen. But I wasn't making videos there, so I have 2 islands which I never used for videos, but I can do that now here. We'll improvise an island, so there you go. Grated lime rind. This goes. Smells. It's a lot better than any perfume, and a lot healthier. I don't believe chemical perfumes are that healthy. Then 1 tablespoon of lime juice. The problem for me is that I speak so many languages that sometimes the words are in my mind, in one language, and I just can't come up with the word in the other one. I had a friend, very, very good friend of mine, who was German and lived in France, and maybe a couple of years before she died, she told me that although she had lived in France for most of her life, the German was taking over. She didn't speak much, she didn't often speak German anymore, but the language that at the end of her life she had in her mind actually was German. That was very, very interesting. As she had been speaking French for many decades, but her own language still took over the French and the English. She was a wonderful person, and I was very, very sad when she passed away. I wished she would be here forever, but she was kind of a mother, a sister, a friend for me. I'll have to ask Sir Colin to open. Oh yeah, it's going. Ooh, it's going to be like champagne. I was used to buy tonic water in little tins, but now it seems like people are drinking a lot of tonic water Maybe they are afraid that with the global warming we'll have all kind of mosquitoes that will bring malaria or something, so they are already drinking a lot of tonic water. There you go, Indian tonic. Indian tonic water. 2 spoonfuls. This is nasty. Let's see if you find that it is a little bit too thick. You just add a bit more. Don't make it too thin though, otherwise it runs all down sides instead of sticking to the top. So do mix well. Again, probably the best way to do this is with a mini food processor, which I have got one, but I was a little bit lazy and I didn't pick it up. So, and that's it. Then afterwards we are going to sit down and have a slice of cake, cup of tea, cup of coffee. This lovely music, Kenny G. I don't know whether it's audible, said Colin. I think Kenny G has faded away a little bit. I hope I didn't make the icing too thin. It's always better to add the liquids bit by bit, because it's better to have a thicker icing than a very thin one, which won't stick to the cake. So I think I've got everything. Now I'll drizzle it on the top. 125 grams of icing sugar. Zest of 1 lime. 1 tablespoon of lime juice and 2 tablespoons of tonic water. There you go. Couldn't be easier. No. Okay. It really smells wonderful. And I only baked the cake for 35 minutes, actually I think 30 minutes would be okay, because this is a very big tin, so the 40 to 50 minutes would have been far too much. Yeah, I added a little bit too much liquid. Always be careful adding the liquid, otherwise all the icing runs down the sides and nothing stays on the top. It always looks like you need more ice, more liquid than you actually do, because the icing sugar absorbs the liquid very well and becomes too thin. I make the mistake I always make of thinking, oh no, this is going to be too little, but then it's actually too much. And then it becomes too liquid. It's nicer, especially with this green color, if it is nice and thick on the top. Never mind. Should do things I preach, and often I say don't do this, don't do that, and then I do it myself, so very wrong. could, of course, add more icing sugar. I won't do that because I still have got quite a lot left over. So actually, you could use maybe 80 grams of icing sugar and then just add one spoon of lime juice and then very carefully add the tonic water. You don't need this amount of icing. Lime rind. I grated it thicker because I find it is prettier, otherwise you probably would hardly see it. So, smells really wonderful. Now I'm going to take a photo. Here is our cake. If I don't like it, I'll be honest. I have no idea what a gin and tonic cake tastes like. It's actually very, very good and very different from anything you have ever tasted. So, Colin, do you want a little
I certainly do.
Taste.
Looks absolutely scrumptious. Just like you.
Tastes very good and it smells very good as well. With juniper berries. And it is very moist with a lot of gin. This surely is one to try. See you again. We'll be back soon, hopefully, with our island in our beautiful new kitchen. I hope you like it, at least as much as I do, although I've still not come to terms with the British double oven, two ovens, one on the top of each other. It's not my cup of tea, but other than that, it's a lovely kitchen. See you soon. Bye. Enjoy a slice of cake. Bye!